Hello, today I'm going to show you how to cut paths and shapes using the scissors tool. Our first example is a simple curved line. Now you will need the scissors tool. You can find it under the eraser tool. Just click on it, hold, and choose the scissors tool, or press the letter C on your keyboard. Now let's zoom in on this line. The scissors tool is mostly used to split a path at an anchor point or along a segment. You cannot use the scissors tool on an anchor point located at the end of a path. Let's cut this path and split it into two separate paths. To do that, make sure your path is selected, then select the scissors tool or press the letter C on your keyboard. Now all you need to do is click either on the segment or on the anchor point. Let's split this path at this anchor point. Just hover over it until you see the word anchor and click. And we've got two separate paths. You can see it better if you go to your layers panel and click on this little arrow to open the sublayers. When you split the path at an anchor point, a new anchor point appears on top of the original anchor point and one anchor point is selected. You can see it better when I move this path away. If you split your path in the middle of a segment, you will get two new endpoints on top of each other. Let's move on to the next example. This time I have two arcs that cross each other. Notice that the dark blue arc is on the bottom and the light blue arc is on the top. I would like to keep only the long segments and delete the short ones. To do that, first select both arcs, then press the letter C for the scissors tool and click on this intersection to make a cut. Notice that we've cut the light blue arc into two segments. You can see it clear when I open the sublayers. We've got one longer segment and one shorter. However, the scissors tool didn't cut the dark blue arc at the bottom. Now, if you select these two segments and try to make a cut at this intersection again, Illustrator won't let you do it. It thinks that you are trying to make a cut at the end point of the light blue segment. To make it possible, you will need to select the dark blue arc, right-click, select Arrange, and bring to front. Now, when you select these two arcs again and repeat the process, you will be able to cut the dark blue arc at this intersection. And here is our desired path. Our next example is a shape without a stroke. Let's cut this rectangle diagonally. Select the scissors tool, click on this anchor point, and click on the opposite anchor point. And you can see we've got a very precise straight cut. Let's move on to the next example. This time we've got an oval with the fill and the stroke. Using the scissors tool on a closed path simply splits the path and makes it open. Let's cut this oval at the top anchor point and the bottom anchor point. You can see we've got two separate shapes with open paths. Any paths resulting from a split inherit the path settings of the original path, such as stroke weight and fill color. If you want to close the path, go to the Direct Selection tool, select these two end anchor points, then right-click with your mouse and select Join. However, this could be useful if you would like to add any points, curves, or lines to it. To do that, select the Pen tool, then hover over this anchor point until you see the little minus sign at the cursor and click on it to continue the path. Now you can add an extra anchor point and change your shape to whatever you like. And finally, I will show you how you can use the scissors tool on text. Let's zoom in on these two letters and select them. Now what I want to do is to cut the bottom rectangle pieces from the letter M, then cut the bottom portion from the letter T and unite them together so it will look like this. To do that, first go to Object, choose Expand and click OK. Next, right-click with your mouse and choose Ungroup. And now, using the scissors tool, let's cut the bottom pieces. First, click on this anchor point, then on this one, and press the Delete key on your keyboard a few times. And let's do the same with the two other pieces. Now select the two bottom anchor points, right-click, and choose Join to close the path. Now we will cut the bottom portion of the letter T. Using the scissors tool, click on this anchor point and this one. To delete the top portion of the letter T, first switch to the Direct Selection tool and then select the letter. Now right-click with your mouse and select Isolate Selected Compound Path. Click on the bottom part and move it down. Then select the top part and press the Delete key on your keyboard a few times. Now click on this arrow a few times to exit the isolation mode. And you are ready to connect those two shapes together. Let's move this part over here. Now select both parts. Go to the Shape Builder tool. Now click, hold and drag to unite these two shapes together. And finally, all you need to do is to delete or move the anchor points to smooth the edges. Let's move the bottom anchor points down. And now you can draw a triangle and attach it to the end to form a zodiac sign. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.